Hello friends, hope you all are doing great. Today is class 10, the topic called allelopathy which I have taken. So let us see in detail about allelopathy. The term allelopathy is first introduced by Hans Molisch. The term allelopathy was first introduced by Hans Molisch in the year 1937 and first defined by the scientist called Rice, R-I-C-E. The other name of allelopathy is teletoxy. Other name of allelopathy is teletoxy. Allelopathy is derived from Greek word which are two, allelo and pathy. Allelo means each other, pathy means an expression of sufferance of disease. So this is the meaning of allelopathy. Allelopathy is derived from Greek words which are two words, allelo and pathy. Allelo means each other, pathy means an expression of sufferance of disease. So allelopathy is defined as any plant which produces chemical substance or biochemical which inhibit other organisms. That means it may inhibit the germination or the growth, or it may kill the any other organism or the plant is called allelopathy. So one plant which inhibit the growth or development of the other plant, that is called allelopathy by producing some chemical substances or biochemicals. So let us see what are the allelochemicals which can be produced by the plant to suppress or inhibit the other plant. Those chemicals are benzoic acid, cinnamic acid, phenolic acid and coumarins, hydroquinones and benzoquinones. These are the some allelochemicals which are produced by the plant to affect on the other. Let us see what are the forms chemicals are released. The first one is vapor, second one is leachates, the third one is exudates and the last one is decomposition products. So let us see the way how vapor is released. The vapor is released in the form of volatile compounds, especially the families are Liberty and Compositae. These are the two families from which the plants which are belong to these two families are exhibiting this type of allelochemicals in the form of vapor. So leaf will give the allelochemicals in the form of vapor. That vapor can affect the other plant. The next one is leachates. Leachates is from leaves by action of rain or dew. That means if you take an example of tree called eucalyptus, eucalyptus will give the leachates, I mean small output from the leaves. Some chemicals will be produced from the leaf, and when rain comes or dew comes, it will, when raindrop hits the surface of the leaf along with the raindrop, these allelochemicals also will get mixed and it will fall on the surface of the soil where and even the on the weeds or the plant, that there they can suppress the growth of the other plant. Then the next one is exudates from the roots. That means, see, this is the example, Circium arvens. This plant will exhibit the or exudate the some allelochemicals from the roots in the soil. Those chemicals will affect the other plant. That's called exudates from the roots. Then the next one is the last one, decomposition products. Decomposition products means after the death of the plant, after the death of the plant, the plant tissues which are in, the allelochemicals which are present in the plant, those chemicals can affect the other plant. So these are the four major forms which chemicals are affecting the other plants, allelochemicals. Then the next one is, what are the forms of allelopathy? So how allelopathy is actually affecting? Being weed management, let us see. First allelopathic effect, the form is weed on crop. The example is jungli pallak, weed is affecting on the wheat crop. That means jungli pallak weed will release the allelochemicals. Those chemicals will affect the wheat plant. Either it may kill or suppress or in other form. See, one thing please to remember, allelochemicals, not all the chemicals will kill the other plant, but they may suppress the growth or they may inhibit or they may kill the plant. Then the next one is weed on weed. The first one is weed on crop. The next one is weed on weed. So the example is cogon grass on button weed. Both are weeds only. So cogon grass is inhibiting the button weed or killing the button weed. The next one is crop on weed. Crop on weed means oat crop or pea crop or wheat crop. These three crops are releasing the allelochemicals which are affecting Chenopodium album weed. The common name is lamb's quarter. Lamb's quarter is the common name. The scientific name is Chenopodium album. This wheat will be affected by oat, pea and wheat crop. Any these crop can affect the Kinopodium album. Then the last one is types of allelopathy. Types of allelopathy, there are two types: true allelopathy and functional allelopathy. If you ask what is the meaning of true allelopathy and functional allelopathy, when plant releases the chemicals, I mean the allelochemicals, those chemicals are ready to suppress or kill the other plant. They are ready made. Those are called true allelopathy. That means there is no intervention. Directly the chemical which is released by the one plant can directly affect the other plant. That is true allelopathy. When it comes to functional allelopathy, when plant releases the chemicals, that those chemicals has to be transformed by the microorganisms, then they will become allelopathic effect or allelochemicals. Till then they will not suppress or kill any other plant. Once one plant releases the allelochemical, those chemicals has to be transformed by the microorganisms. That means one mediator is involving in between to transfer the chemical to become allelochemical to kill the other plant. That is called functional allelopathy. Then another one is there. These are the two types of allelopathy. The other one I'm telling not for type of allelopathy, but auto allelopathy. Auto allelopathy means, for example, hope you all know the weed called Parthenium histrophorus. The other name is Congress grass, we call even carrot grass, Congress weed, we call other names. Parthenium histrophorus is the scientific name, which is came from foreign country. So when Parthenium releases the seeds and when they fall on the surface of the soil, from those seeds new plants will come. Those plants we call daughter plants. Those daughter plants, they also, Parthenium is also having the character of releasing allelochemicals. So daughter plants will release the allelochemicals. Those chemicals will affect the mother plant. So that is called auto allelopathy. That means self allelopathy. Daughter plants which are releasing the allelochemicals which will be affected to the mother plant. Example is Parthenium histrophorus. This is another type of auto allelopathy. This auto allelopathy don't come under types of allelopathy. This is another type of auto allelopathy. Okay, another type of allelopathy. So this is all about the allelopathy. Hope this class is very informative. If you like this class, please like the video. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please do subscribe. Thank you so much.